Welcome everybody to the current session. Over here we'll be talking about what basically a framework is and how the components like JUnit, TestNG and Maven, Jenkins, how all of them they are incorporated with WebDriver to build a framework. Okay, now let's talk what basically a framework is and what is the requirement when we automate the test cases. Right, now if I take up a simple example with you, right, when you write your test cases with Selenium WebDriver, right, suppose these are your test cases. Fine, these are your test cases written in Selenium WebDriver TC1, test case 2, test case 3 and test case 4. Now what are the requirements when you run these test cases? You would want to run them in batch. Okay, that is, you want them to execute in a certain order, or you would want all of them to run parallelly, okay, so that you save on time, or you would want that when the batch run happens only selective test cases should run. Maybe after TC1 you want to run TC2, and after TC2 you want to run TC4, and you want to skip TC3, and you want the whole procedure to be very dynamic. That is, it should be easy for you to optionally run the test cases, right? Along with it, you would want that when you are running the test cases, you would want to generate the reports from the Excel, in the Excel file, okay, or you would want to generate the reports in HTML file, okay. Along with it, you would want certain logs to be generated, that what happened when the test cases were running, okay, what happened at each and every moment. Then along with it, you would want some screenshots to be saved in the reports, right, when the test cases run. For example, a report like this is an extent report which we generally generate with Selenium, okay. This is the test case. I was actually executing it on a mobile, right, so it has got every detail at each and every moment what happened, okay. And if there is some error, you have the screenshot of the error as well in the report. Okay, so you would want a report like this, or a report like this wherein all the test cases are mentioned and you can see the logs of every test case. A pie chart diagram is also present, okay, a pie representation of the reports. So you would want proper reports to be generated with screenshots and logs. You would also want to email the reports in the end to all, auto email the reports in the end to all the team members, right? Also, when you are running the test cases, you would want that your data, the test data, should be read from an Excel file, okay, or you can say XML file or a properties file. The data should be fetched inside the test cases from a certain external file. You don't want to hard code the data, right? Now if you talk about WebDriver, then WebDriver is only this much. This is WebDriver in the blue box. WebDriver will never help you to read the data from Excel files and generate reports. It will not help you. Neither it will help you in running the test cases in a certain order or in batch running. WebDriver commands are only commands which will help you to just interact with the browser. No report generation, no batch running, nothing. So to do all that stuff, you need a certain controller in between, which can facilitate what it can facilitate, report generation and all, everything. Okay, this certain controller is known as JUnit or TestNG. People use TestNG as well these days. It's becoming very famous. Okay, or you would want Cucumber, BDD, right, or JBehave. So all of these are covered in the training, in the videos as well, right? All these frameworks, JUnit, TestNG, Cucumber and all. So you use any one of these controllers. These are testing frameworks, right? You use any one of these, and what they do is that they actually call the test cases in a certain order, the order in which you want. They read the data from a file and they pass over to the test cases. They help you generate reports, logs, screenshots and all, everything, Okay, so the whole thing in a nutshell is known as a framework, that the complete machinery is running automatically. Okay, your test cases are getting executed, data is read from some file, the reports are getting generated, the auto email of reports is happening, right? So to facilitate all these things, you need a centralized controller. Okay, and the complete thing in itself is known as a framework. This complete thing is a framework. Okay, now this is over. What do you mean by the other tools like Ant, Maven, Jenkins and all? Let me talk about that now. Now once you have made your framework, okay, right, you would want that the framework should be executed from a command prompt or something, or there is a requirement that suppose you have got 5 team members in a project. All of them are building the framework. Okay, each team member has been given some test cases. This team member will automate 10 test cases. He will execute 5, 6, 8, 2. So you give certain number of test cases, ask them to automate the tests, and in the end all these team members will integrate their code. Right, so there is a high degree of collaboration required between all of them. Right, now suppose if you talk about the version of Selenium they use, suppose all of them are supposed to use the Selenium version 2.53. okay, then they will download the jar files of 2.53 from Selenium website and they'll start using it. Now suppose if by chance any one of the team members, like this team member, ends up using the version 2.50 of the jar files, then when all the team members will integrate, when they integrate the code, okay, they will face issues. They can face issues because this guy was working with the older version of Selenium. Right, so that is why we use a tool known as Maven. What Maven will do, it does two things. Firstly, it helps you to maintain right version of jars, which should be used by all the team members. The second thing which it does is that it helps you to execute the project from command prompt. Execute the framework, run the framework from the command prompt. Alright, why do you want to run it from command prompt? Because certain times you have got you're working on a shell, Unix shell or something, where you don't have an IDE like Eclipse where you want to execute your project from, so you have to execute from there. So you need to understand how to run it from the command prompt as well. Okay, now if you talk about a tool like Ant, what Ant does, Ant is a build and compile tool similar to Maven, but it will only help you to execute the project from command prompt. It will not help you to maintain the right version of jars. So both these tools are used in the industry. Okay, you can use any one of them. Right. Okay, now preferably people use Maven. Okay, both these tools have been covered in the training as well. So I'm just giving you an overview of what happens and what these tools are. Right, at times you would want to make an exe file. Right, suppose there is another team member who is unaware of programming. He doesn't know how to execute the frameworks through Maven and all these tools. He's not knowing, he's a manual tester. He wants to execute the script. So all these guys, what they can do is that they can give him an exe file which he can execute to run the project. Okay, he can simply change the data in the Excel file, run the exe file, and project will start executing. So to generate that exe file as well, that is known as a bat file, you would use these tools, Ant or Maven. Okay, right. Now coming over to another thing, that is Jenkins. That what is Jenkins? Right. Now again, coming over to the same concept, that is, suppose there are team members in a project and all these team members have already built the framework. The framework development is over. Right? When they integrate the code, they keep the code at a common location of the company. Maybe they keep it in CVS, or these days Git is very famous. Okay, they use Git and they just store the code inside Git. Alright, now the framework development is over. Now comes the maintenance phase of the project. Okay, you have to run builds, you have to run nightly builds, you have to schedule running the test cases and all. Okay, so what is the requirement? You have to schedule the test cases. Okay, now along with that, there comes another problem, right? Suppose this is team member A and this is B, he is C and he is D, right? They have all made the framework and they have kept it on Git. Fine, everything is running fine, and there are three files, X, Y and Z. All three files are dependent on each other. X.java, Y.java and Z.java. Suppose these are the three files. Now what happens is that suppose A gets the code on his machine, and along with A, B also gets the code, that is all these three files on his machine. Now there is no collaboration between both of them, that both of them are changing the code. Now this is dangerous, because suppose A changes the code, he finds that fine, everything is working perfectly fine on my machine. Okay, so what I will do is that I will check back the code into the Git repository. So everything works fine, he checks back the code in the Git repository. On the Git also everything works fine, because everything was working fine on A, but now B is not knowing that A has changed the code since the time B has downloaded the files on his machine. Now B changes the code as well, everything works fine. Maybe he introduces another file known as p.java and he deploys the code onto the server. Okay, and he only deploys the code p.java. Now there can be a very high possibility, 99% of the chances can be there, that there is a compilation error on Git. The code breaks. And the worst part is that nobody will come to know about it. Because p.java, maybe it was dependent on Z and Z has not been changed by P. Okay, and Z has been changed by A. So there can be some problem. Okay, team members should know that who is checking in the code and who is not. And there should be a system through which we can check on Git whether there is no compilation error. Now what happens after this is that suppose D gets the code on his machine, he sees compilation errors, and then the blame game starts. Okay, so now you need a system which can detect the compilation errors as well. So that is why we use Jenkins. Okay, that is why we use Jenkins. Now what Jenkins does is that it will help you to schedule the test cases, the test runs. Suppose you want to run the code every night or every day, or every day at 3 o'clock, or every week, every month, whatever is the time, you can tell Jenkins. Along with it, what Jenkins does is that it constantly keeps on polling Git, say after every 30 minutes 40 minutes. Okay, and as soon as some team member, he checks in the code inside Git, fine, what Jenkins does is that it will immediately run a build. It will start executing the code, and if there is some error, some compilation error or anything, it will automatically email all the team members that fine, something has gone wrong on Git. So immediately everybody will come to know and they will correct it. Okay, the worst part is that nobody comes to know after checking the code inside CVS that there has been some error, and after 2-3-4 days when it's detected and it creates a problem. So Jenkins runs an immediate build. Okay, so this is what Jenkins is, right? And if you actually look at the course, then in the first 17 modules, okay, we have explained the web driver. Then from the 18th module, we have started with the frameworks. Okay, around 40 to 50 hours are on frameworks. Each framework tutorial is over 8 hours. So in that we have shown everything, that how to parameterize the test cases from Excel file, how to generate different types of reports, right, how to run the test cases parallelly, how to schedule the execution with Jenkins and all, everything, integration with Jenkins. So that's what the exact requirement is there in the market, emailing the reports to all the team members. So there are total 6 types of frameworks which are discussed over here, including page object model, data driven, keyword driven, hybrid framework. Okay, and then Cucumber BDD is also there. We have also covered Grid and Maven at the bottom, Apache Maven. All right.